I'm John Hatch, and we're in the Laboratory of Stem Cell and Neurovascular Biology at the National Institutes of Health Clinical Center in Bethesda, Maryland. I study organ development, so we don't have a very good conception of how, in an embryo, organs grow and develop so that they can function when we're adults. So our laboratory studies the mechanisms by which the nervous system and the vascular systems grow and develop in the embryo to form working organs later in life. So I investigate gastrointestinal development specifically, and then I'll use these antibody chemicals to do a protocol that lasts 3 or 4 days in which I stain the structures that I want to look at, and then at the end of those 4 days I'll take them into our microscope room across the hall and spend several hours using the lasers in that microscope to produce three-dimensional images of those organs. Yeah, I always wanted to be a scientist. It took me quite a while to decide that biology specifically was what I wanted to do, and a lot of that just came out of trial and error. So I actually grew up right outside DC, just about 15 miles from here. My dad was a science teacher, and my mom was a nurse, so I was surrounded by science from a very early age. I did my first summer at the NIH in a different lab at the clinical center when I was in high school. And then my first summer of college, I came to this laboratory and absolutely loved it and never decided that I never wanted to do anything else. I like to play sports. I play in a soccer league outside, which is very convenient with the World Cup going on right now. So that's a lot of fun. I have plenty of time to take weekends off and travel, and I do a fair bit of tutoring and teaching.
Happy birthday to you. Yay.
So it's now is it a
surgical technique.
Surgical technique, yeah. You run a lot in 2 years.
There's tons of collaboration within work and with this sort of scientific environment. Everybody's motivated by their research and by their results. So you put in hard work and you still have a life outside of the lab as well. So I'm really excited by developmental biology and the sort of work that we do here, in particular because of its application to what's called regenerative medicine. The idea that when things start to go wrong with your body, rather than do huge invasive surgery or replace the organ or give a transplant, we will, within the next few decades, be able to teach your body to regrow whatever's gone wrong. And that I think will be a major shift in how medicine and disease and damage to the body is treated. Because if we understand how your organs and the structure of your body forms in the embryo, we can teach your body to reactivate those mechanisms to repair really anything that goes wrong. And these applications stretch from diabetes to cancer to traumatic injury. There's no harm in trying something and not loving the first thing that you try. There's so many different ways to be involved with science that you want to get as much exposure as you can to find out what you really like and what really motivates you. I was so lucky that I was pushed to get involved in high school and then right at the beginning of college. And I got to try several different labs before I found one like this that I really loved.